friends, welcome to the first day of Springathon. Yay, it's finally here. I'm so excited. So I thought I would do vlogs during Springathon because I love to talk about nature writing books, and I figured I can add in a lot of clips of, you know, the nature around me. Our spring is not as fully realized as many of you that I like to watch your vlogs and look at your beautiful flowers and all the greenery around you. And I will not be able to share with you that much greenery yet, but we do have some little leaves peeking out and some little flowers showing here and there. So I will be sure to share some of that stuff in the vlog. And I finished my first book already for Springathon. I cheated a little bit. And I blame it on Doris, because any book cheating must be blamed on Doris. We know that. So I started yesterday on April 30th on Late Migrations by Margaret Renkel. And I started listening to it on audiobook. And I read, you know, I read pieces and I listened to pieces on audiobook. And I finished it already today because I listened to it on my walk this morning and then sat down and read the last, you know, 15 essays or so. And it's just an absolutely gorgeous collection of essays all about, as the tagline says, a natural history of love and loss. And this is Margaret Renkel's meditations on family life and nature in her backyard and growing up in the South and her connection with the outdoors. And I just loved everything about this essay collection. It is absolutely beautiful. All the essays are like little short pieces, like maybe one page long to like three or four pages long. And they just tie together so beautifully. It's been a long time since I've read an essay collection, or any collection really, where the theme just stays strong throughout the collection. Everything ties together brilliantly in the end. And it's just gorgeously written, just absolutely gorgeously written. And she clearly has this amazing family where they all support each other through life's ups and downs. And she has been supported enough in her family life to be able to pursue the things that she loves, which is writing. And so much of what she talks about totally resonated with me. You know, parts that she talked about her family really resonated with me, and also you know, her love of observing things happening in the outdoors. She especially is very interested in the birds in her backyard, and she puts out feeders and like birdhouses and things like that, and like just observes what's happening with these creatures day in and day out from her office window. And she's not like a trained scientist by any means, but I actually think that works in her favor because she just has a sense of wonder about what she's observing and this ability to like really discuss it in a way that connects so strongly. I think is just such an emotional connection that she has with the outdoors and the creatures that she's observing. And it just comes through so strongly on the page. Also, the illustrations in this book, let me find one to share with you. Here's one. Were done by her brother, and they go along with the writing, and they are amazing. I love the illustrations in this book. Just beautiful. The writing, the illustrations, everything, the way this book is put together. That's the end papers. The cover is obviously gorgeous as well. This is another Milkweed Editions book. And I will say that every Milkweed book that I have read since we started this adventure with Book Naturalist has been a hit for me. So right now, Milkweed Editions is batting 100% for me in the books that I have read that they have published. So I think that is really amazing to be able to have found a book publisher that just like puts out books that are my jam so strongly. I love it. So yeah, highly recommend like Late Migrations by Margaret Renkel. This book is just simply stunning. It's outstanding, and I highly recommend you read it.